नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज प्रोफेसर एस लाल, प्रोफेसर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स एंड कंप्यूटिंग इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। स्टूडेंट्स, एज पर योर सेशन ऑफ योर करिकुलम ऑफ लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी वंस ए न्यू न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम that will be solved by graphical method, and here you will be seeing that how it is very very practical and very very easy to find the feasible region and find the feasible solution to minimize or to maximize any objective function. So for the sake of understanding of your numerical problem, I would like to share here this numerical problem, and I suggest you that you write this question. Please, firstly, let us write: solve the following problem graphically. Let us write: solve the following problem graphically. Solve the following problem graphically. Solve the following problem graphically. And the uniqueness of this question is that in this particular question, you have to find, you have to minimize, as well as you have to maximize to this objective function z is equal to 3x plus 9y. Z is equal to 3x plus 9y. I hope you have written this, solve the following problem graphically, minimize and maximize z is equal to 3x plus 9y. Again write: subject to the constraints x plus 3y less than or equal to 60, x plus y greater than or is equal to 10, x is less than or equal to y, x is greater than or equal to 0, y is greater than or equal to 0. I hope you have written this numerical, students. This is the question. This is the question. Complete. This is the question. You have to write this question. And I suggest you that just after writing this question, you write what I am telling, what I am explaining. You write, and there is no need to see on this part of the solution. There is no need to see on this solution part of the numerical. You will be observing this, you will be understanding this when I will be coming to the, you can say, pattern of this graph. So please write solution. I am going to solve the numerical. Please write solution, and then write: it is given that, please write, it is given that we have to just discuss about these constants in solution. It is given that x plus 3y, this x plus 3y less than or equal to 60. X plus 3y less than or is equal to 60. This implies that x plus 3y is equal to 60. Means you have to write the corresponding equation of this. X plus 3y less than or equal to 60. This implies that x plus 3y is equal to 60. This is equation 1. Then the next question is, the next equation is this. X plus y, this is an equation, x plus y greater than or equal to 10. So write its corresponding equation. This is x plus y is equal to 10. Take it as equation 2. Take it as equation 2. And you can write this also, x is less than or equal to y. This is equation 4. Here is also equation 1, 2, 3, 4. So what I am telling you, that is in Roman letter. Means you have written x plus 3y is equal to 60 in Roman. 1. X plus y greater than or is equal to 10, 2 in Roman, and x is less than or equal to y, this is 4, this is equation 3. Now by the method of inspection we are going to get solution of equation 1. What is equation 1? Please see. Again, you see, please, this, your equation is x plus 3y is equal to 60. So, please write here, now, from equation 1, x plus 3y is equal to 60. So, when x is equal to 0, then 3y is equal to 60. X is equal to 0, then 3y is equal to
Hello students, sorry for interruption. There was a call from admin department. So please continue. You are solving equation 1, x plus 3y is equal to 60. X plus 3y is equal to 60. So this is x is equal to, putting x is equal to 0, you are finding 3y is equal to 60. So y is equal to 20. Therefore, point is, please write, point is equal to xy. Means what? 0, 20. I hope you are getting me. What you have put? You have taken x is equal to 0, then you are finding 3y is equal to 60 in equation 1. Then, if 3y is equal to 60, then y is equal to 20. When y is equal to 0, then x is equal to 60. Then the point is what? Xy means 60 and 0, and this is the second point with the help of equation 1. Again, we are going to solve equation 2, that is x plus y is equal to 10. Put again here, when x is equal to, write please, from equation 2, when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 10. When, so point is equal to 0, 10. And when y is equal to 0, please write x is equal to 10. So the point is xy means 10, 0. So students, here again you have two points, 0, 10 and 10, 0. Means you have four points with the help of these two equations, and the points are 0, 20, 60, 0, 0, 10, 10, 0. Now, come on the graph portion. There is no need to write all these things, whatever here is mentioned, this is not of your use. Now you take x-axis, take here, x-axis and y-axis. And the point you have taken is, the maximum value of x is 60. That is 60, 0, so you can take here interval of 5 or interval of 10, you can take 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, and so here is 60. This is the value of x, and y is up to what? The maximum value of y is 20. So we are here reaching up to 25 on y axis. And now the first point is 0, 20, as you have written. So 0, 20 is what? 0, 20 means the value of x is 0 and y is 20. So this is the D, 0, 20. Then the second point is 60, 0. Means x is equal to 60, y is equal to 0. This point is here. X is equal to on x axis, this is 60 and y is equal to 0. The third point is 0, 10. 0, 10. X is equal to 0, y is equal to 10. X is equal to 0, y is equal to 10. This is 10. 0, 10. And the third point is 10, 0. 10, 0. X is equal to 10 and y is equal to 0. This is 0, 10. Students, in this way, you have two different graphs, two different lines. First line is this, and second line is this. And there is also an equation in your question, that is x is less than or equal to. So by writing x is equal to y in the corresponding equation, it will be x is equal to y. X is equal to y is not containing any constant, so the line will be passing through the origin. So this is the line. X is equal to y, this is the line for x is equal to y. This is for x plus y is equal to 10, and this is for 3x plus y is equal to 60. Now, this line is cutting at two points, at these and at these. So while the coordinate of this point will be obtained, you can solve x plus y and x is equal to y and x is equal, x plus y is equal to 10. So you can find, solve x plus y, x is equal to y and x plus y is equal to 10. Put y is equal to x, then you can find 2y is equal to 10, means y is equal to 5. If y is equal to 5, then x is also equal to 5 because x is equal to 5. So this is 5, 5. Again, you can solve this equation, x plus 3y and x plus y. Then you can find this value, 15, 15. In this way, now, as usual, our target is to search that which are the feasible region, which is the, which points are representing feasible region. So, satisfying by origin, the inequations, these inequations 1, 2 in your questions, all these results are not satisfied by 0, 0. If you put a is equal to 0, 10, a is equal to 0, 10 means x is equal to 0, y is equal to 10. Then this is equal to 30, 30 is less than 60. So this point is satisfying the result, and this is also satisfied by this point, by this point, by this point, by this point, with the by all these points a by all these points a b c and d. These equations are going to be satisfied. So this region, as you can say, this colored region is feasible region. Now you have to put all these value consequently in your this, in your this result. So you have taken A, B, C, D and you have put the value. So the maximum you are getting is 180 and the minimum you are getting is 60. So you have to minimize and you have to maximize. So the minimum value is 60 and the maximum value is 180. I hope students you have got this, and I hope that you will be doing all these things. This session is powered by digital version 2.0 of Jyoti Vidya Peeth Women's University Jaipur. In case of any query, you are suggested to write your comment in the inbox. I shall try to resolve your query from there. Thank you.